Now that we have our single choice node, it's time for us to make our multiple choice node. The only difference between the single choice and the multiple choice nodes are their type and the way they lay out their output ports, or choices. Let's start by creating a new C# script in the elements folder and name it dsMultipleChoiceNode. Again, make sure to at least have the multiple choice part of the name here, or whatever value you've given in the dialog type enumeration. It is also important for the rest of the name to be exactly the same as a single choice node, without the single choice part. Opening it up to the usual thing of removing the default methods and inherit from dsNode. I'll be making it part of the element subnamespace, meaning the dsNode class will now be recognized. We already made our dsNode methods virtual, so let's go ahead and override them. We'll import the enumeration namespace and set our dialog type to be of type multiple choice. Then we'll add one choice only. This is going to allow us to see how it will look like, but more importantly, make it so it always starts with one choice. So simply type in choices.add and I'll name the choice new choice. In our draw method, we'll be adding two things. The add choice button to our main container and our choices to the output container. Let's start with the nodes by looping through the choices, much like in our single choice node, and create an output port as well. We can use the single choice port code here, as it will most likely be the same. However, in our multiple choice node choices, we'll actually have a button to delete a choice and a text field to update its text. We will do that by creating them and add them to the choice port itself. So let's create a button and make sure we import the UI elements namespace and not the UI namespace. And I'll name it delete choice button. I'll pass in the value of x, as that will be the button text. Then let's create a text field which we will use for the choice text. I'll name it choice text field and set its value to be of choice. When we are done, we simply add these two elements to the choice port through the add method. But do note that the elements here will be drawn from the right to the left, so if you want the button to show first, or on the left, we'll need to add it as the last element. There is still something left to do and that's updating the port name. As things stand, we'll have both the choice text field and the port name label. However, we do not really need a label here as we'll be updating our text through the text field. And with stylesheets, we can make that text field look like a label when not editing it later on. We won't really be removing the label, but simply make its text to be empty. So go ahead and update our choice port name to be an empty string. Make sure you are adding the choice port to the output container. After the choices, we'll add in our add choice button to the main container. I'll actually do this above the choices code, so simply create a new variable of type button, to which I'll name addChoiceButton. And give it the text of addChoice. We won't be giving it any functionality for now, so let's just add it to the main container. However, because I want the add choice button to be above the top container, I'll use the insert method instead, because right now it will add under the extension container. So swap the add method and type in insert and place it at the index 1.